Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, we are going to be talking about how to tag a PDF. There are multiple methods to tag a PDF, including manually tagging the content using the reading order tool, auto tagging, and using the action wizard. So if you have a Microsoft Word document that you've applied styles to and exported it properly to PDF, you will have a nicely tagged document. But if you're using a program like Adobe Illustrator to create accessible PDFs, it's gonna be a lot more challenging to tag them. And remember, not all documents were created equally, so make sure to review the tags panel to ensure that everything is working as expected. Let's take a look at how to do this in Adobe Acrobat Pro. First document that I want to review is a document that came out of Microsoft Word. If I open up the tags panel, I can quickly determine that there is tags in this document that were properly implemented. For example, I see a heading level 1 for the topmost element. We have paragraph tag, H2, paragraph, H2. We also have a table tag with the appropriate amount of rows and columns. It doesn't look like any table headers were applied, but this is how the document was intended to come through from Microsoft Word. This section is going to cover how to manually update content in the tags panel. The first thing I want to do is I want to make sure all of my tags are underneath a document tag. I can select F2 on my keyboard, and between the brackets, I can type the word document, or I could right click the tag, select properties, and change the type from the drop down menu. Because this document was appropriately styled in Microsoft Word, it's challenging to find some content that needs to be added. I'm opening up a new version of the same PDF, but this document has no tags in it whatsoever. The first thing I want to do is create a document tag, as this is where all of the rest of my tags will appear in the tags panel. So let's open up the accessibility button and then the reading order tool, and let's start applying some tags. I can simply draw a box around the content I want to tag, and then select the appropriate option from the reading order tool. Now you may notice there are several options missing, like links and list items. For this, let's select heading 1. Next, I'm gonna select some paragraph text. But before we get to that, I'd like to ask you to hit that like and subscribe button. This will notify you anytime that I upload a new video. Right now I'm doing 1 a week, but the plan is to up that to 2 or 3 accessibility videos that will be posted weekly. So let me help you get accessible. Back to the video. And select paragraph. And then I'm gonna select issue 1. Sometimes you have to move your cursor pretty high up to get all of the contents. Issue 1 is gonna be a heading level 2. Then our color and meaning will be a text paragraph. And in this example, this is not an actual heading, it is just text paragraph. And we can simply go through and tag all of our content. Let's select this entire table using the reading order tool, and then let's tag it as a table. Oh, we also have an image down at the bottom that we can select as a figure tag. I'm gonna select close. I'm going to move the tags out of this section tag because I like to have a clean tags tree. And if I expand the rows in this table, I can determine that the top row was correctly identified as a table header. So using the reading order tool in the PDF actually created my table more accessible than it did from the Microsoft Word version. Let's open up a brand new version of the document. And this document also does not contain any tags. But this document, I want to launch the Action Wizard. Now the Action Wizard is gonna walk this document through a series of steps and get it to a mostly accessible version. So to do that, I'm gonna launch the Action Wizard button from my Tools panel, and then I'm gonna choose Make Accessible from the top right corner, and then I'm gonna select the Start button to begin. The first box that appears is the metadata box. This is where we could enter in our title, sample, and author, and select OK. Next, it's gonna perform OCR on the document. It then will ask us if we want to identify form fields. This particular document doesn't have any, so I'm gonna say skip this step. Then we're gonna set the reading language of the document. And the next option will be to add alternate text to any images in the document. I'm gonna select okay, and it takes us to our first image. Going to apply some alternate text, select next, and select save and close. And then the final step of this process is to start the accessibility checker. And it appears that according to the accessibility checker, I only have an appropriate nesting failed. So let's go into the tags panel and quickly take a look at that. So it looks like that it applied an H2 to my document, not an H1. That's one error we would need to fix, and we could do that using the reading order tool or simply press F2 on the keyboard to update the tag. We also don't have a document tag. It did also identify the table perfectly. And now we really only have a few steps to fix this document. Let's open up another sample of the same document. Now, the last thing that we're going to test to get tags into our document is the auto tag feature. To launch auto tagging, I'm gonna select the accessibility button and move my floating head. And at the very top of that window, there is an auto tag document selection. When I select that, we'll apply a tag structure to my file. To review, I'm gonna select the tags button and expand the menu items. And it appears to have applied the same level of tagging that the action wizard did, where we begin with an H2 at the top and we have several other tags available. So that gives us the brief overview of how to get tags into a document. If you wanna check out some more practice videos on how to do these things, please check out the description of this video. As always, thank you for watching.